beachgoers bring lots of stuff to North Carolina's sandy shores. But it's safe to say these are not your average beach toys.
Today we're using rip current drifters to measure the velocities and the distance that the rip currents are pushing offshore. Each of these units has a GPS unit inside it that records its position every second. We put them in the areas where we think the rip currents are likely, and it records the data of which way the circulation is going, how far offshore and how far along the shore it changes.
A rip current is essentially a strong current that moves away from shore.
Rip currents are on the beach every single day, but only a few days a year they get to be very dangerous velocities. So maybe 4 or 5 days a year in most beach towns, they get to be fast enough where people are at risk of drowning.
While rip currents don't usually pose a danger, they are still the leading surf hazard for beachgoers. The National Weather Service reports 7 rip current-related fatalities along the North Carolina coast in 2013. The U.S. Life Saving Association says almost 80% of all rescues are related to rip currents. There are 2 types of rip currents. Just follow the floating beach ball and you'll understand. Recirculating rip currents start from the shore and the water flows out towards where the waves are breaking. The current essentially bounces off the wave and heads back towards the shallows and then back out to sea. Think of a merry-go-round of water recirculation. Exiting or ejecting rip currents usually start when multiple waves break together. The force of the wave pushes the current out from the shore and it breaks through the waves.
We're thinking, well, there's no one perfect answer you can give everyone. Everyone's different, rips are different, so it comes back to prevention.
Which is why Bob Brander has traveled from Australia to study rip currents along North Carolina's coast with North Carolina Sea Grant. Brander identified the more permanent rip currents in Australia, which features large wave beaches with natural features, such as sandbars.
The rips are similar to what we get in Australia, although the ones in Australia, they're much more pronounced where they sit in these deep channels. We call them fixed rips between the sandbanks. They're really predictable. You know, you always know where they are. And what we find with those ones when we put the drifters in is you get a lot of recirculation a lot of the time. Not all the time, but a lot of the time. But you know, here today on the beach, we do have a rip that's in a channel. It's going off at an angle. And we have been getting recirculation, but we've also been getting exits.
But the rip currents along North Carolina's coast are smaller, shorter in duration, and difficult to predict. Researchers believe that's because the North Carolina coast is so varied. The slope of the surf zone changes. So do the sandbars and the height and the direction of the waves. There are also plenty of man-made features that affect the surf.
So the results of these studies have huge implications for what we should be telling people about if you get stuck in a rip, what should you do?
Researchers are deploying the data logging drifters at several points along the coast to document the velocity, circulation, and ejection frequency of the rip currents. The long-term hope is to create a computer model to better predict when and where rip currents will occur. But even then, researchers say, the ultimate answer to saving lives remains with educating the swimmer.
We can do all these measurements and we can argue, oh, it's better for people to swim parallel or it's better for people to stay afloat. But we need to ask the people what they feel about that. So there needs to be a social component. And that's what this survey is about.
And so researchers are surveying beachgoers as well to measure the effectiveness of rip current safety campaigns.
We're asking people, you know, how often you go to the beach? Do you know what rips are? When you got caught in a rip, you know, what were the conditions? What did it feel like? Did you remember any advice about what you should have done? And then what did you do? So we're asking about their physical response, their emotional response, and also how did you end up getting out of the rip?